Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and the new iPads Pro or iPad Pros, depending on who you ask, Apple would say it's iPads Pro. They have USB-C and you can charge your iPhone using that. So if you have the correct cable, USB-C to Lightning, you can actually charge an iPhone off of it. Now if you're using USB-C to USB-C and plugging in a MacBook, it actually goes the other direction. The MacBook will charge the iPad Pro. But I wanted to see how long it would take to charge the iPhone XR, and I chose the XR because it's somewhere in between the size of the XS and XS Max battery, and you'll see I've drained this down to 5%. And it's at 5%, nothing is open in the background as far as apps go, and I'm going to test it just like it was real world. So I haven't turned anything else off. What we'll do is we'll turn the screen off, it's set to 30 seconds anyway. And then on the iPad Pro, let me take the pencil off of it and then remove the folio keyboard cover here. And what we'll do is unlock it, and you'll see that this one is at 95%. So we've got plenty of battery. Maybe you're out and about and you're getting low on battery on your iPhone. We'll charge it. And what we'll do is we'll see what it charges at 15 minutes, 30 minutes, and then 1 hour, and then see how long it takes to fully charge it. So let's plug this in the bottom here. And this cable, you can get it from Apple or whoever you'd like to get one from. And let's go ahead and we'll hit start as soon as we plug this in. And we'll give it 15 minutes. So we'll give it 15 minutes. We'll turn these screens off and see what it does. And we'll come back and see how charged we are. Hopefully we're quite a bit. So we have 10 seconds left for 15 minutes. Let's take a look at what we've got here. And we'll stop this. We're at 18%. Let's stop this and start it over. So we'll give it another 15 minutes, but we're at 18% here. And on the iPad, we're at 92%. So we've drained 3% on the iPad and gained quite a bit on the iPhone. So let's give it another 15 minutes and see where we go from here. We have a second left. Let me cancel that and see what we're at. Now let me change this to 30 minutes before we take a closer look, and we'll hit start. So we are at 31% after 30 minutes charging from an iPad, and the iPad itself is at 86%. So it's doing okay. It doesn't really rapid charge, but we've gained quite a bit, 26% in 30 minutes. So that's pretty good charging off an iPad. So let's see what we get after 30 minutes. It's been a total of an hour, and let's start this again for another hour and see what we get to. So we'll put this to a minute, an hour, we'll hit start, and we're at 57% after 1 hour of charging, and we're down to 74% on the iPad Pro. So we'll give this another hour and see where we're at. It's been 2 hours, and we'll see what the iPhone XR is at. We're at 97%, and the iPad is at 56%. So after 2 hours, it charged it almost the entire way. 92%. So I would say at the current charging rate, we've got probably 10 minutes more and we'll charge 100%. So we'll check that, and it should be charged in just a few minutes, it looks like. So I'll check back when it's full and we'll see what it took. The iPhone is 100% charged. It took until 1:30. So we went from 11:10 to 1:30, so 2 hours and 20 minutes to fully charge off the iPad Pro. Now in that amount of time, the iPad Pro actually used about 45% battery. So you might be able to get two charges out of this if you needed to while you had your iPhone, if you were in that sort of situation. So that's kind of interesting. Now if you had a XS Max, it may take a little bit longer since the battery's larger, or maybe a little bit less depending on what phone you have. But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Is this something you'd actually use? And would you charge off an iPad if you needed to? Or is it just something that it's nice to have, but you'll probably never use? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.